Hi everyone, welcome back to Divinity Original Sin. Let's go in here.
There's a seafaring atmosphere about this place, and seafaring leads to the exotic, to trading.
Guardians. Oh, guardians, I need you. Heed my plea in these void-filled hours. The dragon is overpowering me. Our enemies are battering the fragile gates of time. The skies are darkening, and the stars are being extinguished. You have to reach me. Star stones will pave the way. Find them, use them, empower them, and hurry. Please make haste.
Only Star Stone can stay the maelstrom now.
Can I be honest with you?
Damnable stuff is hidden better than a leprechaun's pot of
the fuck's going on? Like we missed so much here. And it's just like all of a sudden story out the fucking wazoo. Oh look, dude, this guy's here. The mysterious stranger.
Ah, fancy finding you here. It's such a very small series of worlds after all.
Fancy finding me here. What business could you possibly have at the end of time?
If I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. I'm just tidying up a bit. Ensuring that all's running smoothly. Every gear well-oiled. Every cog in its place. Nothing special.
And what, you've got to do that here of all places?
Well, why not? It's an interesting sort of place, isn't it? And speaking of interesting sorts of places, you must have seen some fantastic things on your journey so far.
Yes, it's a parade of magic, mayhem, and mystery all from the top to the bottom.
The mysterious stranger gives you a hard look, as though trying to discern something deep within your eyes. After a moment or two, he appears suddenly satisfied and slowly blinks.
Kay. Well, done with him.
Okay.
The fuck is this place?
Welcome, welcome, step right up. Browse these fine goods from far-flung fairy worlds and local slums the same. Take your time or don't. Time is meaningless after all.
I think I found your place, Kent.
Yep, I had a feeling.
Yeah, this is definitely your place. I want some of these dyes, though.
An auspicious ogre.
I need to get the green dye some of Yoshi. Dude, he has pizza, too, on top of that. Alright. Well, I'll take my leave. I'll have fun with that. There's a shit ton of chests here. Alright, I've decided I want to be Yoshi. No, I need more crafting abilities to make myself into a Yoshi. You know,
first world problems.
No, it's fine. It's fine. I'll send it to Joanne. It's important to me. I just hear you in the background. My lucky stars. All right.
Fun fluids, man.
What the hell? New recipe: large intelligente potion. Large dexterity potion.
What are you gonna stop saying that?
Never. Large strength potion. Okay, that's pretty good. Let me see if there's anything else we missed here. Oh god, there's a dog here now. There's a party animal. Cat is a party animal. You need to get over here.
Can I stop till fine.
You can do it after the fucking we're done recording. The party animal, Cad. Where the fuck is he going? He went in here.
Getting drafty in here, isn't it?
Okay. Well, you missed the party animal.
No, I saw it.
I think you didn't. Let's see if we can unlock the last place. Where did Zigzags go? Oh, here he is. I think he's done. Yeah, he's literally done with us now. But you know what? Fuck you. We're using the fucking bloodstone.
Bloodstone.
What? What?
Pardon.
What?
Pardon me.
What? We used the bloodstone and they got pissed at us? Zigzags is also our enemy. Or is he an enemy?
I don't.
What the fuck happened? All right, you know what? I know everybody's an enemy with us now. I'm gonna just load it. I think I loaded it. I saved it pretty recently.
What did you do?
I fucking used a fucking bloodstone. Yeah, let's just run away. Flee combat. Just say flee combat. Enemy's too close. Let's try that first, okay? Okay, just flee combat. Flee combat.
Are you out of combat right now?
Yeah. Great, now I'm in combat again.
It's fun that I flee combat. I'm out of combat, it's fine.
They're running to us now. This did not work. What the fuck happened? Why did they fight us now? I guess I'll have to load it. I'm just trying to figure out how long it's been since... I think it's been a long time since I've saved. I'm not gonna lie. How the fuck would I expect this to happen?
Mike.
This is retarded. Like, why did they get pissed at us? One sec. The good thing is that these guys are all allies with us now. Maybe we could just kill these guys. Can we just leave? Can you go through the portal behind us?
I just left through the portal.
Yeah, do that.
What happens if we just stay here?
I'm good with that. Let's just do that. What's Zigzag doing? He's hastened. Their attitude is negative 45 to us now. Where are you at, though? Go through here. Let's see what happens.
All right.
I guess I'll go back through and I'll see what happens.
Combat.
Otherwise, we have to load them. We have no choice. Yeah, no, they're cool with us now. It's all fine. It's fine now.
It's like, oh, those source hunters.
Just save it here. Just get the fuck over here so we can do the last thing here. Are you here?
I'm here.
Where are you? Oops. Shut up. There we go.
My friends, we come to it at last. All of the missing threads have been rewoven, and the canvas is clear for the first time in eons. The final mystery may at least reveal itself. The final thread of your memory may be restored. Let us watch.
The Guardians had failed. Source was tainted, the void was loosed, and all that stood between Rivalon and annihilation was Astarte herself. Overcome by guilt, they hoped to undo their failure by undoing reality itself. And so, they ripped their threads from the tapestry of time, so becoming unknown to history and unknowing of themselves for all eternity. As their threads fell to Rivalon like shooting stars, they hardened into crystals the people called Starstones.
3 out of 4 have already been reinstated, and now the last of the elemental shall rejoin its illustrious masters. Glory be unto them, and glory be unto you.
Alright, that's it. The last one. Alright.
So the souls within us intentionally tore themselves from the tapestry of time.
Perhaps it was the only honorable thing to do after the tragic opening of the God Box by Astarte.
Duty is honor, and honor is duty. I can understand their not being able to live with having failed to protect the God Box.
I don't even know how this is our fault. Astarte did
it. It's so cold in here.
Guardians, I ask of you, what are you doing? What good can come of your misguided actions? I have tried to warn you. I have tried to be your friend by pointing toward the one great truth that is the Void Dragon and say, relent. For you have failed before, and you shall fail again. Why is it so difficult for you to accept that which is inevitable? All things must pass away, even time itself. Sit ye down, rest, be weary no longer. Acquiesce in the embrace of oblivion, in which there is nothing but the equality and the harmony of non-existence. A blessing awaits beyond the end of time. Accept it, for it is yours to receive.
Friend, that word has truly lost all meaning.
By the hoary beard of Boreas, can it be? You've come. You've come home. It's about time, isn't it? Your quarters have been invaded by all manner of madness.
What do you mean by calling this my home?
Could I be more explicit? This place is of your essence. Can't you feel it in your very bones?
I don't know what these fucking people are talking about.
Every crystal of frost within me. You belong here, and this place belongs to you. I cannot tell you why or how, but I know it to be true.
Okay, so there's some good abilities here. Mass healing. Nice. Mass slow I already have. Winter blast seems kind of neat. I would take hail attack from here. Actually, no, that's master. I guess cleansing water then. Get cleansing water from this guy. Where's the last book? There's always a book in these areas. Oh, here, ancient letter. My fellow general. Okay.
Just cleansing waters is all you want?
Yeah, because all of them are master then. Alright.
I've seen the void and it haunts me.
Well, I guess that's it for here. You want to go get that bloodstone?
So you can aggro the imps again? Yeah, sure.
I'll be sure to use it not in here.
I gave it to Jan.
Okay, where are you at? Alright, we're gonna teleport over to Boreas' prison. Because I remember that thing being a starstone, so I think if we kill it, we'll get it. Eberheim prison. Because we've really missed out on this stupid shit. Alright, it's not gonna just do this thing. This is deactivated, right? I guess it is.
Yeah.
What level is this, this person here? Level 10 Iron Maiden, alright. Put out its misery. Fuck, it killed him in two hits. Oh, there you go, Bloodstone.
Striking it rich!
Alright. Where are you? Come here.
Bloodstone, as powerful as it is sinister.
Alright, we can go back to the end of time. That was easy. I don't think we actually have anything else after this. Oh god.
You know that I have been giving your history a lot of thought. For any historian worth his salt duly contemplates the events he records and researches. It is my solemn conclusion that you have been treated rather harshly, and that the harshest punishment of all was delivered unto you by your very own hands. For tell me true, what are humans worth, even if they ascend to the status of demigod, if they be void of all doubt, if they question unfailingly their duty? The demon abused a most primal emotion, and because of that, that emotion has been dubbed a weakness. Nay, I say, it is not. Indeed, it will save us yet, be it in the very last nick of time. So, chipper up, eh? Not like the near impending end of all is entirely your fault.
What a nice guy.
At least Zigzag seems to think we Guardians aren't utter failures.
Bless his heart, for he is right. Doubt is not a blight, but a blessing.
I couldn't agree more. In fact, I'd go so far as to say we didn't fail at all. That may have been the gods' conclusion, but it isn't mine.
Alright, where do you go now? I saw him run over here somewhere. There he is. The chapel.
I wonder who awaits you in the next...
A chapel? I have the feeling it has long since been abandoned by the gods.
Oh, guardians in whose hands rests the fate of all. I know he, the usurper, the instigator, has been trying to charm you. Charm you like he once did us both before. Do not listen to him. Do not listen. For every sound he makes is another vocalization of deceit. And what is more, a ruse to mock his weakness. First he seems to mock you. Then he seems to menace you. Then he seems to mesmerize you. But all the while, what he really does is fear you. His desire has been long in the making. The freedom among the void that is his unfathomable dream. But I have stopped him once, and you can do so again. You have pieced yourselves back together, guardians. You are greater now, perhaps, than you ever were. The maw of the void is chomping with big black teeth. But there is still time to kill the beast. Rise up, guardians. Stand up! Come to me at the center of the maelstrom, and stand by me!
Our enemies fear us.
And well they should. We'll hit the void in the jaw yet, and put a halt to its ceaseless devouring of creation.
Alright.
Fucking story of the video game.
Story of the video- well, we missed a lot here. Dude, what the fuck, the eyes?
This enshrine a most honored soul, yet it seems almost lonesome among the gloom here.
You have an opinion on it? No? Okay, I'm gonna touch it.
Your... why? Your home? How long it's been? Centuries? Eons? Since you've come to me in search of salvation. But I have not changed nearly so thoroughly as you have. My offerings remain the same, dear protector. As have my prices.
Holy shit, huge potions.
Potions of great and incomparable strength, dear protector, as ever. During the Great War, you found full resistance to the elements quite useful. Perhaps history will repeat itself.
Yeah, look at the potions he has, by the way. Insane. I see you've already looted the chest. Alright. Assuming that when we get out, Zigzag isn't gonna fucking ambush me again, we're done with this place. I mean, there's only one other bloodstone I can think of, because there's that talking totem. It's probably, like, taken over by a bloodstone, but yeah.
Mike.
What?
You missed something.
What did I miss? Should I teleport back there?
Yeah, you should.
The Guardian, and the General before that.
Has time erased all memory of me? It is I, Alessa,
The general who stood by your side when the Void Dragon first plagued our world so very long ago. Three of us faced our foe that day. Only two lived to tell the tale. You stared the Void straight in the eye and saw oblivion reflected back at you. You broke, panicked, and it took me the very depths of my magic to rally you once more. Rally you I did, but I was spent, and the dragon did not hesitate. Thus I perished in the jaws of the Void.
Then let me beg your forgiveness for our breakdown, which cost you your life.
Indeed. We're sorry we failed you, Alessa. Praise be that you restored our courage.
There is nothing to be sorry about, Guardian. I did what had to be done, and after that, so did you. You did your duty and more. You gave up the rank of general to become something greater, something immortal. Guardian, protector of the God Box, protector of all creation. Oh, how terrible it must have been to be betrayed, to hear a Astarte whisper, to falter ever so briefly and see the dragon rise anew.
Pick one.
Choose!
That was our darkest hour. To err is human, but we were immortal. We failed creation and failed the gods.
It was a moment of weakness that we are paying for still. Long as the Void lives, all of existence remains under threat.
You shouldn't blame yourself. It would be an injustice to do so. You undertook a task, after all, that the Seven themselves should have presumed. And where are they now, these allegedly all-powerful gods? Cowering in a distant universe, no doubt. But you are here, ready to face your fear yet again. Destined, I am sure, to succeed at long last. To succeed and save time and space forever. Your moment is nigh. The moment of final failure or final triumph. I know what shall be. Your time has come. The Void is destruction. You are creation. The greater force that will best a lesser foe.
Our past. Another in a long line of the Void's wretched victims.
Come what may, we'll avenge them all.
Okay. So, a little bit of story has happened in these last couple of episodes. Just a little bit.
A little bit of combat, too.
Oh, just a little bit. Alright. You know what we can do? How about we give the imp that fucking recipe, the fucking potion? How's that sound?
That's what I've been saying to do. I want to do that.
Well, where's he at? He's at, like, the... I know where he is. We'll fucking go do that now.
Let's go do it. I wanna add him to our harem.
Harem fucking trolls. Holy
imps
shit.
Imps, they're imps, my...
Blowjobs for days.
Yeah, imp, have some liquid courage. Come sign our petition.
Would you like to sign our petition? Alright, I'm trying to remember where I found the door. Okay, I'm going to the door. Where the fuck is this? It's the closest place to the fucking place. I'm pretty sure this totem has a bloodstone in it, but we'll just keep that in mind for maybe later. Because we have a whole other area to explore, so...
I'm overheating here!
I don't feel like fighting all these fucking assholes right now. But we'll probably do that eventually.
You can probably take him.
Star stones.
By the way, Yahan leveled up.
Who cares? I mean...
Demons.
Fine, let me look at his fucking level ups. He's got 3 points available. And I'm gonna save them all just because we fucking... He gave me that ability here. Can I even take cleansing water right now? Nope. Only up to 3. I have all these blank skill books. I've never used them.
I think you can use scrolls to turn into skill books.
I don't know. Alright, let me go give this guy some liquid courage.
Shouldn't have done it.
No, 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 bad yoks, bad!
Here, take this elixir of courage.
Oh, my friend, you'd give your only elixir of courage to a cowardly little yok.
I actually have another one.
Yoks will never forget this generosity. Something's happening. I feel like climbing a tree. No, a mountain. I think my blood's turned to whiskey. I think I could slay a dragon. I think I could face Master.
Okay.
Nolalim, you gotta come to our homestead. Report to the Normandy at once.
Where's he even going?
He's going on an adventure.
Then he's gonna go fucking talk to his master. Oh, that's right. His master's outside, isn't he? That's the one, because he knocked him off. Alright, well, I guess we might as well just go outside there. I keep forgetting we knocked him off. He's getting slowed. Oh my god, this could take so long.
He's still following him? Where is he?
He's down there by where the guy died. But he's dead. I don't even know what the fuck the point of this is. You just wanted to come back to our homestead.
Yeah, and?
My master! Cold and dead! Taken before his time! Well, I'll just be on my way then.
Oh, that's it.
No, get back here.
No, he fucked off fast. That's a fast.
Man, he went to the void.
he ran right to the snowstorm or whatever. Sandstorm. There's no snow.
He ran straight into the Darude.
Alright. There's Hunter's Edge, which I think is in the next area. I think we have nothing else to do here. There is absolutely nothing else we have to do here. We are completely done this area. So now we go to... We actually now go to Phantom Forest, guys. Finally! I think this is what is the last part of the game, actually.
We are really done with everything else?
We actually are. Like, I mean, there's a bunch of, like, mini-quests that we never did. But fuck them. Like, they're really small. And they're really, like, they're, like, now, like, level 5. They're not worth our time. And I don't care that much about that. Like, we don't need to do everything.
To Hunter's Edge. North to incomparable suffering. Well then.
Let's go to incomparable suffering then.
For now, at least.
No, I don't want to go to incomparable suffering. Southeast. Okay, you want to go this way? Yeah, let's go this way. Yeah, let's go fucking. Midori needs to use Hunter's Edge.
Of course it's Edge.
She needs to face her demons. My name is not important.
Madora pulls out a fucking bloodstone out of her ass.
Yeah, actually, that's where we can get another one. We already know about that one, actually. I'll do this tangleweed here. What the fuck's this?
Oh my god, it's gonna be like one of my Japanese hentais.
Apparently it is.
No, yeah, Han, don't die to the burning poison. Oh my god!
Well, he's fucking dead.
My screen is still has health!
Yeah, he does to me as well. Can I move him?
No? Yeah,
he's dead. Fucking Rip dead.
It. Fucking, I got like 14 resurrect crawls. I really need to dim these up a bit more.
Dude, I used one too.
Oh my god, we got two!
We got two yards! Duh.
How you doing resurrect crawls, by the way?
I think that was my last one, actually.
How's it your last one? How many you used?
I don't know, I never got any more of them, that's why. Yeah, that was my last one.
Sweet. Give me just split them in half and give you the fucking...
Okay. Give me. We almost made two Johans. We almost made a fucking multiply.
We almost made the fucking true nightmare.
Fucking source.
Oh my god, this is like fucking... This is mud crabs.
Mud huntress. Apparently they're weak to air, so... Weak to air, and yeah. So let me put on my air wands. You want to kill them?
You know, this is the time to buff. I'm gonna just buff.
How do they do it for fire? Shit. Is it time to buff? I think fire wants it.
I'm just going in.
Fuck. Okay, go ahead.
Hey.
No, I wanted to fucking have one more fire wand. There we go.
Oh, what? Sorry, you weren't done preparing?
I'm never done preparing.
You know I've never done.
You're the one in the front, so.
Once I decided, no, I'm doing my buffs and I'm going in. Fuck you. I have to wait for you.
You're fine. You know what? And now you get to be the one that's in the front going like, why is the door not doing anything?
Hello. Goodbye. Oh my god!
That's the worst ability I've ever seen.
It's the worst ability ever in the game. Literally unusable. Come on, Midora, there you go. You can do better than that.
Holy shit, Midora actually did something for once.
Midora, can you do a lot more? Oh, you can do a bit more.
Truly, Santa Claus is real now.
Holy shit, it's Christmas. This hunter knows what's up. Oh my god, Flank Lobster! Oh my god!
I need help.
Oh god, it's like I'm confident. Look how much blood I made!
I want to go there. Crawling infestation failed.
Don't you strong?
42% chance to avoid it. I think it's that thing that in 3 turns it'll fucking kill you. I want that to be a thing. Come on, do it.
You try it again?
Aww.
Doris unbreakable.
Why does it not work? Why doesn't
it work? Juggernaut, bitch!
Why does this guy get a turn again?
Yes! Why me? Why me? Oh!
Ow! Piece of shit. The fuck is their movement? Why don't they
want
to fight Midora?
They got filled like 100 arrows, okay? They're hurting. And I think all those guys are dead. Just focus on the guy next to you. Yeah, they're all dead.
No.
It might say they have health left, but no, they don't.
No, you're gonna fucking deal with that guy next to you.
No, I'm gonna deal with the guys I've had. I'm gonna deal with both. Mike!
What?
Mike! Just please stop with the guy next to me, come on!
Why?
I need your help, you're the only one who can do this.
Fuck you.
Only you can save these lives. Stop wasting. Stop!
Get fucked on. I can't do anything else. Oh, that guy came back. That guy got back up.
Midora, just don't do anything, Midora. It's fine. No, Midora should do something. Fine. Oh.
She did nothing.
Another grandson. There we go.
Really?
Yeah. Now I feel better. You know, because you charmed it, I'm not gonna be able to arrow spray it, right?
Fine, I'll fucking hit it then. I'll uncharm it. Not working.
Yep. Don't you dare freeze it, I swear to god.
Nah, it's just stunned, it's fine. You told me to handle this one.
I told you to deal damage to it, not fucking... Oh, it would have been perfect, Mike. I was gonna ricochet arrow all those guys, kill them all. And then I was gonna fucking machine gun this guy down.
Should've just started with that, you fucker.
I started with my other ability to fucking put them all, they're fucking dead. the worst ability in the game. Oh.
You didn't kill it. Doesn't count. You missed.
How did that miss?
Nice. It's stunned and not moving, and you have fucking perception bonuses. I need to slurp up some of his fucking health. And spider health.
Delicious. I'm spider health.
Meet your demise.
How have you not killed the last one? What's wrong with you?
How is he still up?
He's knocked down, but... Knocked down,
you know, this guy gets the big arrow.
Holy shit, 1,000 damage.
Told you, man. Big arrow. Yes, Medora, stand in the fire.
What's the deal with Hunter's Edge? Yeah, I just can't wait for Medora to have that fucking final fight. God, we need to hear fucking Medora's story. Oh shit! No, Joanne!
Does it always happen to you?
Without aid, I will expire soon.
I think I'm dead too. No, I lived. It's fine. Wasn't even close.
Not even close, baby.
Joanne just is just having fun, okay?
I'm just liking the amount of, like, he's pretty gung-ho about blowing things up.
No, I just keep walking into shit that kills me. To be honest, I can just unhook him and not die. Because these places are very suspicious when I walk into them, okay?
Are they?
I'll just look at this fucking shit. Come on. Tap one look at that and tell me that that wasn't going to kill me the minute I walked into that. Actually, that wasn't the way it was before.
This thing is very resistant to dying.
Okay. You have to do damage to it. Nothing I can do. When I go near it, it's gonna fucking piss off at me. Okay, Joanne, I'm unhooking you, okay? You're grounded.
I'm trying as best I can, but this thing just won't die. You know what? Hey.
I needed that.
One sec. There we go.
Sodden all the way. Oh god, it's getting rainy and shit.
It's getting shit. Oh dude, I think this is Hunter's Edge. Oh no, there's just cats here, never mind. Well, the cats recognize Medora. Let's save it before we do this.
Oh, there. A word of warning, Wanderer, before you continue on your merry way. See these corpses here? Be a good fellow and take them as a hint that this town isn't the pastoral little paradise it once was. That immaculates, orcs and humans both, have taken Hunter's Edge. Its villagers are now slaves in the mines of the west, or they've been bled dry of their last drop of life, reduced to mere fuel that must light the wicked candle that is Bloodstone. Long as you live in the limbo between coming and going, though, why not have a look at what I have to sell? You'd be surprised to see what a scouring skeleton can gather together in a dying town.
Anything vital I need to know about Hunter's Edge?
Yeah! Well, don't go round angering immaculates if you want to keep your vitals intact. Though perhaps it won't be very long before they have a stab at one another's vitals instead. I have the feeling there's trouble brewing between the orcs and the humans in there, and who can blame them, really? Just ain't natural for them to consort, I say. Only good orc? Well, you know how the phrase goes.
And who are you exactly?
Can't say I remember who I was before the change came over me, but these days I'm a travelling trader of sorts. There's an immaculate necromancer in the village ahead. She's the one who brought me back from, well, wherever I was. She's an especially bright one, you know. Most necromancers can only revive a dead corpse into an animated one, but she manages to yank back some semblance of consciousness too. I don't remember much, but the thrill of trade certainly calls to me. Maybe I was a merchant in my former life. Who knows? These days, Most undead are busy haunting Cycele or picking the way in the Lucula mines. But I keep a low profile and stay out of sight. I haven't been bothered by an Immaculate yet, and I hope to keep it that way.
Apparently he's a trader though, so he's got a lot of things to trade. It's a real shame you didn't go into fucking crossbows.
Oh man, I hate to break you. I know you want to get some combat done, Mike, but...
What?
I spy an Ahu.
Why is Ahu here?
He's by the Scarecrow.
Might as well. I never said I want to get combat done. We did get combat done. What is he doing here?
How can I help you, my friend?
He didn't really say anything, actually. Ahu, what are you doing here?
I'm watching on with weary eyes how the Immaculate strike again. They've gone from shedding blood among their own to recruiting orcs and cutthroats to do it for them. From what I can tell, the village of Hunter's Edge is this cult's most wretched victim.
What have you discovered about this place?
Hey, it was once a quiet sort of village. Families and small-time merchants mostly. Recently, it was targeted by a tribe of orcs waving the Immaculate banner. Their leader, Grutilda, is known far and wide for her cruelty and cunning. She oversaw the murder of countless villagers and used their blood to fuel a great number of bloodstones. Once they were dead, they were reanimated as undead corpses and sent to work in the mines of Lucula. By order of Leandra, the orcs were joined by a tribe of humans from the northern peaks of Tanneroth. A band of male warriors are they, and they devote allegiance to their leader, Jarl. Jarl arrived with his own formidable supply of bloodstones, which means his tribe has been operating under directions from the Conduit for some time. Where once they ransacked for base pleasure and material gain, now they do it by the will of the Goddess. These are far from the blindly devoted Immaculates of Silverglen, however. The orcs and the humans here alternate between bitter fighting and hostile peace. Personally, I believe they're best exploited through their rivalry. Get them to fight each other, and you can stand on the sidelines and warm yourself upon the flames.
Yeah, not selling anything good, really. Well, he's got one good wand. Infectious Flame.
Hey, you!
So I can wait on it.
Come on, time's a wasting.
Zendalar lives in this village. Got any pointers for me?
He has a residence at the far end of town. Though I have my doubts he's having people over for tea now that the Immaculates have landed. Know that Zandalor is wily, so beware. If a wizard doesn't want you in his home, you'll know it. Pity the intruder that heedlessly tries to waltz his way into that dwelling. Nevertheless, his house is the very place you'll want to search. The accumulated knowledge stored there is quite phenomenal, and beyond a doubt, one of Leandra's most urgent pursuits.
I'll take my leave. Let's talk to this cat.
You can speak. You don't look like a tribesman or orc, but I suppose I can't be certain. Then again, I've never heard of a dark soul gifted with the speech of the wild.
Seeing you found another feline friend there.
Oh, that bothersome old Tom. No, he and I are hardly friendly, much less friends. I've much more important things on my mind than him and his incessant pestering.
Tell me about yourself.
Jinxica is my name, and until recently I lived a placid sort of life among the people of Hunter's Edge. The baker might leave me a bit of milk left over from this breakfast. The barkeep stroked my back between filling glasses. I had many friends here, but none so dear as a little trio. A married pair and their daughter, employed by the wizard to keep his home. They spent many long hours squashing fleas that plagued me and shared their warm beds with me each night. If you come to this village to help and not to harm, you might be able to save those three kind souls from the orcs that have invaded. Ugh, such misery in our sad town.
What do you know about this wizard?
A kind but private man he is. He set up his home here several years ago, but never remained there long enough before jetting off to tend to some matter or other.
The Dark Invaders seem very interested in him indeed. They've been skulking around outside the house since they arrived. But not even one of their filthy vermin can penetrate the wizard's protective enchantments.
Say orcs invaded this place?
Would that an invasion were all! They destroyed every crumb of life they could find and sent their filthy rats to seek out those who evaded them. Each life they took infused their strange stones with power. Their queen glowed with delight as a parade of victims were slain before her. It was as though she was taking in a beautiful song. The human tribe came shortly after. They had their own supply of the glowing stones, and the orc queen took no easy liking to them. Still, it seems they are working towards some similar goal. They haven't destroyed one another yet.
Tell them about your friends, the wizard servant.
They've survived this carnage so far by concealing themselves most cleverly. I've done my best to guard their hiding place from the slime-bellied rats attempting to sniff them out. But I fear my efforts aren't enough. Until the village has been rid of vermin, those three sweet souls may be found at any time.
So the orcs are using rats to their advantage.
Savages by savages employed. The orcs have one among them. The rat catcher, they call him, who claims to have trained rats to do his bidding. They've swarmed the place in search of hidden villagers, and unless every last one of them is split from tail to snout, they're sure to find my friends. But you're not like the brutes inside those walls. No, you approached me with hand, not boot, outstretched. Perhaps you could help me. With these rats running about, it's only a matter of time before my friends are caught. They must be squashed, every last one of them! I've done my best so far, but there are simply too many for one set of claws to handle. With your help, though, with your help, it could be done! The rats gone, my friends! Safe!
I'll take my leave.
I can slip through these walls as I please, but you'll need to find your own way into the village. And remember, my friend, kill every last rat you find, or three dear souls will be lost.
Alright, that's it for that one. Alright, well, that's all the time we got for today, guys. Next time we'll continue in Hunter's Edge here, so take care, bye.
Goodbye.